I'm Priscilla Barrera with the Investing News Network, and here with me today is Steve Yuzpe, CEO and President of Sprott Resource Holding. Thank you so much for joining us today, Steve.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
All right. So we're here at day one of the International Mining Investment Conference in Vancouver. How are you finding the event so far?
It's been great so far. Really good presentations, great companies presenting.
That's good. And today you gave a presentation about copper and the future for the metal. Can you tell our audience why you're bullish on copper?
Certainly. It really boils down to both at the supply and the demand side. On the demand side of the equation, I think people see it in their daily lives, the emergence of electric vehicles. They use significantly more copper than internal combustion engines. We're seeing electric buses sprouting up. In fact, China is purchasing and deploying 9,500 electric buses per five-week period. That's the equivalent of London's entire working fleet every 5 weeks. Renewable energy projects use significant amount of copper within their guts. A wind turbine, for example, uses 3.6 tons of copper per megawatt. And so on the demand side, we're really seeing demand growth, you know, beyond the historical growth in copper demand. On the supply side, there's been significant underinvestment, which has meant that there haven't been new discoveries made, and we need those new discoveries now in order to bring new supply in down the road. And the grades of the existing copper mines producing copper today has been declining. So we have both long-term supply and demand support for the metal.
All right, and so let's talk about supply first. We know the mines, the current mines are aging, grades are lower. Where will new supply come from? Where geographically will we find that new supply?
Well, I think there are a number of regions in the world that are endowed with great copper resources. Our favorite happens to be Chile. Chile has the largest concentration of world-class copper porphyries in the world. It is the number one country for global copper production, and it's number one for global copper reserves as well. But 29% of the world's copper reserves is in Chile. So there's a lot of copper in Chile.
And in terms of demand, you talk a little bit about the electric car sector. Will the market see the impact right away? Is that yet to come? What are your thoughts on that?
It's yet to come. Now, every electric vehicle uses three times as much copper as an internal combustion engine vehicle. That's about 165 pounds of copper. But we still need to see a lot of electric vehicles sold before it really has a noticeable impact on demand. But it's coming. The expectations for electric vehicle adoption is very high. The other part of the equation, though, is that the charging stations and the infrastructure required for electric vehicles also uses a lot of copper.
All right. And we've seen copper prices go up. Will copper outperform gold this year? Are you expecting that?
Well, I'm at Sprott, so I can never say anything negative about gold or silver.
Okay.
We do expect copper prices to remain strong, though. And really, it goes back to that underpinning of long-term supply and demand fundamentals.
All right. And I guess you mentioned gold and silver, but are you interested in any other commodities this year? Are those the ones that you're interested about? Or?
Definitely. So number one on our list at Sprott Resource Holdings is copper. But just after that, we are, you know, we're bullish on gold and silver. We like nickel. We like zinc. There are a number of the metals that are used today in the new economy and the green economy that we still think will make fabulous investments.
All right, and my last question for you today, what would be your best piece of advice for someone new to the sector?
If you're new to mining, I would say do your research, study the company, understand what you're buying, and know why you're buying it. So if the circumstances ever change, for the better or worse, you can revisit your investment decision.
All right, Steve, thank you so much for joining us today.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Once again, I'm Priscilla Barrera with the Investing News Network, and here with me today was Steve Yuzpe, CEO and President of Sprott Resource Holdings.